So let's have a look at this then. What gets capitalised? First of all, what we mean by this is what gets put on the SFP under PPE or under assets. Okay, what goes there instead of going to the income statement as an expense? So that's the question. What things go to PPE or other assets? Okay, well, I'm looking at PPE in particular in this question. So the sorts of things that get put to PPE, obviously, if you're buying plant and equipment, or if you're buying property, etc., then these things definitely get put there. But I'm thinking of, you know, some of the more tricky things that might come up in the exam. So what also gets put in there is all the costs necessary to bring it in to its working condition. Okay, so all the costs necessary to bring it into its working condition for its intended use. So this would be not only obviously the cost of the assets, but it'd also be the cost of maybe preparing the site for it. You know, if it's a big item of machinery and you need to prepare the site, that would debit PPE, that would go to PPE. Delivery. Any delivery costs, a postage and packing. That's part of bringing it into its working condition. And so that will also get added on to the asset. Installation of it. Any professional fees that you had to pay because of it. All of that will help bring it in to its working condition. So we're thinking here of architects or engineers' fees. Also the cost of dismantling, which means taking it down at the end. And as we see in other assets, cost of dismantling and removing and restoring the site, that needs to be discounted down, discounted to the present value of that figure. Okay, and that's pretty much that, really. Things that don't, therefore, get put to assets are definitely things like advertising for the asset, training staff, those sorts of things. Okay, let's have a look at some questions.